Welcome back guys, this is Vishu from SavageCamp and in this video, we are going to generate random phone numbers and convert it into an US number. And what I mean by US number is the way Americans use their numbers is they have an area code, so it would be 123, then they have some random 3 digits, then they have another 4 digits. But the format is always like this. The first 3 tells you the area code. So a certain area in the US has an area code of 123. And if you see someone's number starting with 123, you can basically tell where they got their number from. So that is how the area code works. Now let us start with writing a phone number. The first thing that we need to do is create a random phone number. From random, import choice. So choice will help us choose random digits and we will import strings. Now, if you don't remember, we made a password generator. Let me try to find where is the password generator. And we had string.ascii letters, digits and punctuations. We only need digits over here. I will print string.digits and this will give me 0 to 9. So we have 10 numbers over here to use. We will start with creating a blank variable. Then for I in range 10, which would be 0 to 9, number plus equal to, which will be, let me make this more clear, number is equal to number plus choice of, we will have to put this in digits and I am going to put it over here. Let's print out print number. Now we have a number being generated in front of you. So you can see first it chose 5, then it added 8, then it added 1. And like that, it generated this number. Now we don't need to print all of this out every time. So we will print it at the end when the loop is completed. And now we have random numbers being generated. The first part is done. We have generated a random number. Let's do this 20 times. We will put this in a for loop. For x in range 20, I will select all of these and press a tab. It will bring it inside the for loop and every time the loop starts again, it will clear up the number and generate a new one. So now we have random numbers. The next thing is to format it in a way where it is bracket with the area code, then some random 3-digit number, and then the last 4 digit. There are various ways you can do this. You can use regex. If you don't know regex, you can just YouTube. It's pretty interesting. It looks weird, but it is very, very helpful. And I would highly recommend everyone learn about regex. In this case, we are going to keep it very simple. We know strings have indexes, and over here, if I type print number and I will also print out the type of number, it is going to give me a string. So we have strings, and the beauty of string is I can do number of suppose 0 to some random number like 6. It is going to format the number according to the index that I give to the string. So we have indexes available to use and we will make use of it right now. We will print out the original number. F random number is number and we will print formatted number. let us create the structure. So it's the area code hyphen random numbers hyphen four random numbers. What does the area code include? The first three digits. How can I get the first three digits? Let me open idle. 1, 2, 3. S is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 0. Now, if I do S of 0 to 3, it is going to give me the first three digits. Now you get the idea. If I want the next three digits, I will do 3 to 7. So 3, 4, 5, 6. So that's 4. So let's do 3 to 6. This is giving me the next three numbers. And if I do 6 to, I don't specify, it is going to give me the last four until the end of the string. So you get what we have to do right now. Just format it like that. This would be num number of 0 to 3. This would be number of 3 to 6. Number of 6. And print this out. US formatted number is formatted number, and let's put a divider so we can distinguish the output. And you can see every number has been generated and then formatted in the US way. So it's a pretty fun exercise. I really like this because it's kind of tricky until you get what you have to do. You can certainly use regex, but this works just fine. And I really like this method. I like to keep it simple. So I think that's it for this video. And I will see you guys in the next one.